Howdy folks, welcome back to the channel. It is February the 22nd, 2022, and I'm doing a little spring cleaning this afternoon, dusting the heat sinks and motherboards and so forth. In fact, I got most of that done, but just to give you some idea, I've been having to get down there on the finer detail stuff and get this dust, you know, out of my case. And this is just a process that I do. I'm going to finish it up. There's still some cleaning that needs done, but I do this every, see, look at that. That's terrible. I do this every 6 months or so because I've seen computers, you know, that don't get cleaned out and how bad electronics can get. It's a pain in the butt, but they are dust magnets. But the real reason I'm here is to discuss my 1080 Ti. I'm thinking about swapping this thing out because when I originally got this 1080 Ti, you know, I was doing content and I needed a really heavy, beefy video card for both playing the latest games and, you know, recording at the same time. And now this thing is a bit overkill for the stuff I do. So I'm thinking about putting it up on eBay and selling it because the market right now for GPUs is crazy. And this is an actual gaming GPU. It's not been mined on. And although it's a blower style fan, let me see if I can turn my light on. You can see that in there a little better. Even though this is a blower style fan, and keep in mind, I'm still cleaning the dust out, so she is a little dusty. The reason I went with this is because a traditional 1080 Ti, you know, with a cooler on it, like this little R9270, would not fit in this case. In fact, I had to cut this piece of frame out just so I could reach down in there and get the power connectors. Now, I know a lot of people hate blower style cards, but one of the advantages that blower style cards have over more traditional cooler type cards is they'll actually fit in places that normally other full-size cards wouldn't fit. And that's the reason that I went with the blower style 1080 Ti from Asus, kind of like a sleeper build. But also, not only would it be difficult to get bigger cards up in there like that, and trust me, I have tried. There's a lot of cable management going on. When you have a small enclosed case like this, and I know a lot of people hate blower cards, but aside from them being able to fit in tight spots, they also work as secondary cooling because everything, all the heat is being sucked into the card and blown out the back. While as a card like this in a tight space, it just exhausts all over everything, and hopefully it gets sucked out by the case fans. You know what I mean? And really, the only case fan I have on this build is right here. So what happens is my power supply unit brings in hot air. It dumps it all right here on top of my SSD and my graphics card, and then my graphics card sucks it out and exhausts it out the back. Not the best cooling situation to be in. But yeah, I got a 1080 Ti, and this one, well, I got this 1080 Ti, and it served me well. I mean, it is still, even in 2022, a beefy-ass overkill of a card for the gaming that I do. I mean, it will play pretty much any modern title, VR, etc., no problem. And the reason I went with this card is, one of the reasons I went with this card is, like I said, I was doing Star Citizen, Space Engineers, Rust videos. I wanted a card that had a dedicated video encoder built into it, and that's on this particular card. The 1080 Ti does have the NVIDIA, what's it called, NSYNC or whatever, not the boy band.
When you record or stream your gameplay, you take the frames coming out of your GPU and compress them into a smaller format. This is called encoding. It saves space but also decreases quality. There are two types of encoders, software and hardware encoders. Software encoders, such as X264, run on top of your CPU, and the quality they output depends on how much CPU you dedicate to encoding. This means that your game and stream have to share the CPU, so you lose FPS in-game and have to limit the quality you output. Hardware encoders run on a separate piece of hardware, decreasing the load on your CPU and GPU to run the game. At NVIDIA, we developed the NVIDIA Encoder, or NVENC for short, a dedicated hardware encoder running on an independent section of our GeForce GPUs. We introduced it a while back with the GeForce GTX 600 series, and we have been improving it since then. NVENC takes the load off your CPU, lifting a massive strain from your system. This in turn ensures that your GPU isn't bottlenecked, giving you better game performance because the CPU and the render cores of the GPU can focus on running the game.
An encoder directly on the card. So if you're playing a game that's really heavy on your GPU and really heavy on your CPU, and you're wanting to record at the same time and do content, or maybe even stuff in the background, this is an ideal beast for that, because it's got a separate chip and stuff to encode the video. So that's the prime reason I got it. But I no longer do, you know, gaming content. And most of the gaming that I do, like I don't do videos and stuff. And most of the gaming that I do, you know, is pretty light stuff. Older stuff. Like Elite Dangerous. Maybe VR chat. Various RPGs. You know, I don't need all of this beast of power right now. So I'm thinking about putting this little R9 270 back in here. Or maybe even what I'm really thinking about doing, possibly, see, I have a WX7100 workstation card, and it's a single slot unit. And I might just put that single slot WX7100 in here, because I tried to use the 7100 for cryptocurrency mining and it just overheats too much. So I might swap it out and use it instead, because it's a real small, fine card. I'm just curious what it would be like to use one like on a regular basis. Like I said, my WX7100 has been used for crypto mining. But that's the advantage of this thing, is it has not been mined on. You could mine on it, and I've thought about maybe putting it in a mining rig and mining on it, because, I mean, in a year, it would definitely pay for itself. But again, it's hard to find good gaming cards. You know, cards that have literally just been used for gaming, no mining whatsoever, or maybe a little bit of light mining just to see how they'll do. So yeah, I'm thinking about swapping it out for that. And I kind of like I mean, I know there are different flavors of gaming cards. Some people like to show off and stuff, and other people like to have sleepers. This is more of a sleeper. This thing is an absolute beast. Go look up reviews and stuff on the 1080 Ti. Even in modern times, it is still an absolute beast. 11 gigabytes of video RAM. Still a monster. And again, really overkill for me. And the markets are, like, insane right now. So I figure, you know, I'm getting ready to go back to school and stuff. I'm not gaming a lot. I need the money. There's definitely some gamers out there that would love to have something like this at a reasonable price. I don't know if I'll be able to price it reasonably or not. But, you know, it's been cared for. It's been taken care of. As you can see, I'm cleaning her up and dusting her now. Getting all the goop off of her. And who knows, I might even put this little fucker on the market too. I actually got the Star Citizen. When I was playing Star Citizen, I had the little voucher for the R9. Or not the R9, the Mustang Racer version. The R9 Racer version for Star Citizen. I threw the voucher away when I got this card, because I didn't think I'd ever play Star Citizen. But I played a lot of Star Citizen on this card. And, you know, with Vulcan and stuff, even though this is a 2 gigabyte card, this card itself, for the price, I think I paid $150 with this, and I had a mail-in remake. know, for the price, new, this thing's been adequate for me in a lot of things. It hitches a little bit now because the video RAM is short. Like when you run out of video RAM, and it's got to refresh the memory, especially on an older system like this where I don't have exactly the fastest hard drives and regular RAM and CPU and stuff. It does sort of do like the hitch thing whenever it totally refreshes the memory, but that's aged like a fine wine. I mean, that's a good little card still. If I don't swap them out, I'm going to be selling this guy too, regrettably, because I've got a lot of workstation cards in there as a content creator and a crypto miner. I mine, like, I sort of understand where the gamers are coming from as a gamer myself. You know, it sucks for crypto miners to be buying up all the video cards, you know. But I also got into some light crypto mining too. But the crypto mining that I did and I'm still doing is on workstation cards. So I didn't want to buy into the gamer market. And all like the work, like the 3D graphics and modeling and stuff that I do and the artwork and stuff is on workstation cards too. But, you know, like I said, I've got that WX7100 in there. Eventually, I'm going to sell that WX7100, which has been mined on. The WX7100 has been mined on. But I want to use it for about a year or 6 months or whatever to make sure that it's not been got any issues or damages. And plus, I want to see what it's like just using like a workstation card as a daily driver, too. I think it'll fit nicely into this case. So I'll probably put these two bastards up for sale. I really hate to see this R9-270 go, though. This was like my, like when I used to game really, really heavily. When I used to do Star Citizen and trolling videos and Rust and everything, it was on this card. And yeah, I'll hate to see her go. I really will. It'd be difficult. This one, not so much. I mean, I got the 1080 Ti to replace that because I thought, yeah, I'll need it. But then I stopped gaming, basically. And, yeah, it was just overkill. I mean, it was really overkill. This is a monster card. Even though it's the Turbo Blower edition, it is still a freaking beast. Even in 2022, probably going, this card will probably be good for the next 5 years, no doubt. And if you're not going to game on it, it will still turn a profit. It will ROI easily. It's retail price, you know, mining cryptocurrency. You can go look up stats on 1080 Ti's when it comes to both gaming and crypto mining, but I've never really mined on this one. I threw it on there a few times just to see what its hash rates and stuff would be. And I said, no, you know what? I'm keeping this for the gaming. Also, like, the kind of the styling, like this, the plain jet black. Would have been really cool, though, is if, this is if anybody wants to do a theme. Instead of the silver lines, if you were to paint these red and paint the Azus red, sort of have, like, a Knight Rider or a A-Team vibe going for it. That's what I think of every time I look at this card, is I think of the A-Team and the Knight Riders out there. But yeah, I need to get back to cleaning and dusting this old case out. And also, before I close down, look at my SSD's situation out there. What I did, I got a X4, or maybe it's an X6 PCI adapter. I didn't have a full-length PCI, but I had like these little miniature PCIs. Like that one right there, it's got a piece of tape on it. Yeah, gotta get rid of that. It must have fallen off of something. But do you see that like little mini PCI? That's what this is hooked up to. I had like three or four of them lined up. Most of them are blocked by the video card, but these two top ones were open and free. And I said, well, what can those be used for? Because I want to get the maximum use out of this thing. And I figured I'd put some hard drive storage in there because I think they're rated at like 400 megs a second or something. It's plenty fast enough for a hard drive. So if you've got any of those and you know, you want an extra hard drive space, they do make adapters for that. Also, the final notes in closing down. I need to change this processor out now that I think about it. This is a little i3 3240, I think. And I'm thinking about putting an i7 in there. Because Windows Mixed Reality doesn't want to work with this. Like, the other VRs will, but Windows Mixed Reality won't. Because it's not got enough cores. It's just a little dual-core hyper-threaded. And I've noticed an i7 will fit down in there, but I hope I don't have any problems with that. I hope it's just an all plug-and-play, no issue thing. Just take the heatsink off and reapply the thermal paste, and bada bing, bada boom, it fits like that. I think that's how these type of socket processors are supposed to work, but I don't know. But I would like to get an i7 in here eventually. Especially if I'm going to be downsizing on the video card. Because if I do any more recording or video processing or editing and stuff, I can maybe offload that onto the processor. That's the other reason I went with the 1080 Ti. Wanted to do the big GPU, little CPU deal thing. And it worked out pretty good for many, many years. But yeah, just wanted to showcase that while I was cleaning it out. I can feel this dust getting in my lungs, so I need to finish my job here. Get back to work.
If you found this video useful or entertaining, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, as it really helps the channel out. You can also leave questions and comments down below. Until next time, take care, thanks for watching, and bye-bye.